the high octane, edge of your seat, thrill ride that is professional chess, has been rocked by an explosive letter.
Dear Chess World,
a very polite explosive letter.
Cheating in chess is a big deal and an existential threat to the
we
game.
We must do something about cheating.
I hope the truth on this matter comes out, whatever it may
Sincerely,
be.
Sincerely, Magnus Carlsen.
The drama began earlier this month when reigning chess champ Magnus Carlsen withdrew from the Sinkfield Cup after just three rounds, announcing his withdrawal on Twitter with this cryptic video.
I prefer really not to speak.
Carlsen had just suffered an unexpected loss to American teenager Hans Niemann.
Chess speaks for itself.
Ending a 53-game winning streak.
People assumed that this was an implication that Niemann had cheated.
So, was Carlsen on to something, or was it just sour grapes after losing to this guy?
I think he's just so demoralised because he's losing to such an idiot like me, you know?
But Niemann has admitted to cheating in the past. He claims those days are behind him, but not everyone is convinced. He's been banned by the website chess.com, his coach has himself confessed to being a cheat, and the internet has been on fire with rumours that he's being secretly instructed using, wait for it, vibrating anal beads.
Anal beads to electronically stimulate the right answer for chess.
This week, the argument intensified. In an online tournament, Carlsen and Niemann squared off once again. And after making just one move, Carlsen resigned, as seen in this explosive video.
And what?
What? Magnus Carlsen just resigned, got up and left, switched off his camera, and that's all we know right now.
Speechless, yeah?
I believe Niemann has cheated more, and more recently, than he has publicly admitted.
So can the chess world resolve this calamity, or are they trapped in a classic stalemate?
Wanted to get to the bottom of this, so I caught up with US Hall of Fame Grandmaster Maurice Ashley earlier to help unpack this scandal. Maurice, thanks so much for joining us. What a story this is. Has the dark underbelly of competitive chess just been exposed?
Wow, when you put it like that, it sounds positively nefarious. Well, it is a very sad thing for chess now that we're seeing these allegations of cheating. And certainly it's not something that the world of chess wants to be famous for, especially after the popularity of the Queen's Gambit brought so many new fans to the game. But now we're seeing that with the advent of AI, these engines that can help crunch chess moves that even the best players can't compete against, I'm terrified. I mean, it's ridiculous. The authorities really need to try to clean this up.
So how does Carlsen think Niemann's cheating?
You know, that's the $64,000 question, and nobody knows exactly how this may be being done. I mean, there are all kinds of speculations about devices that may be hidden in various body parts. I can't believe we're talking about the great game of chess. But in believing that somehow this information is being communicated to Niemann from the outside by some kind of hidden device, and he has got an accomplice, which would mean that it's a bigger conspiracy, if you will, than we all know.
Tell me about vibrating anal beads.
I don't want to. Please don't make me. I mean, simply outrageous. But the idea is simply this. Chess is an information game. And any bit of information, you don't even have to tell me the exact move. Just tell me that there's a great move on the board, something special that I need to look for. That's all I need, a hit, a wink, a nod. Anything that says, look for something special out of the ordinary and a grandmaster can find it.
So just to be clear, we're talking here about some kind of bead that is around that region that would vibrate at a particular time to alert Niemann to either a specific move, like, I don't know, three vibrations for the knight, two for the bishop, something like that. Is that the idea?
Look, the idea is that this device is hidden. Where it is hidden is on everybody else's imagination.
Okay.
Obviously, it could be hidden anywhere. It could be in a false tooth, if you will. I mean, that's not as sexy an area for people to be talking about. But, I mean, it could be hidden anywhere. And so this is why people are speculating in the mad, mad world of social media that we live in, that ideas like this just get purchased and everybody runs with it.
Maybe it says something about us that we've gone straight for the anus. He has. He has offered to play nude. I mean, he can't do much more than that, can he?
Clearly, he's not going to play nude. He's just saying it. But He was upset in that interview that has now become famous. Neiman was upset that he's being accused of all this. So what can he do? I don't know. He hasn't said anything recently. It looks like he's lawyered up. It looks like Carlson potentially is lawyered up. Everybody is worried about potential defamation suits. We might be hearing about million-dollar settlements in chess. Simply outrageous that it has come to this, but it is the time that we live in.
Maurice, it's an extraordinary story. I was not expecting that this year this would be one of the big stories of it. Thank you so much for helping walk us through it, and thank you also for having such a spectacular chess-themed background.
Well, thanks very much for having me.
Extraordinary chess, though.
If he is not a cheater, though, doesn't it just go to show that, God, world sport is, you know, they're always going to take down the disruptor?
Oh, right.
Yeah.
Are you on Team Neiman?
I'm Team Neiman.
Oh, wow, that's a big declaration.
Yeah.